very much, Speaker. As indicated in the annual report of 2013-2014 and the quarterly reports 2014 and 15, that the department supported smallholder farmers by giving their production inputs, e.g. pig farming, poultry farming, maize, and also supported communities, with small community food projects and homestead food gardens. Would the MSA please indicate, one, whether these are pilot projects? If not, why they are not fully rolled out to create employment? Two, how many black farmers are supported by these, and how has the department intervened so that these farmers are able to sell their produce goods? Number three, whether the government would consider buying back these products? Four, please supply the location and the contact details of all smallholder farms, location and contact person for the agricultural community projects. Number five, please supply the name of the schools where agricultural projects were supported, location, contact, and the contact details of the agro-processing that was supported. Thank you.
Honorable Sophie.
Thank you so much, Honorable Speaker. It's quite a lengthy response, Madam Speaker. I'll make the response available to the table to you. On the first question, whether these are pilot projects, the response is no. The cooperatives and emerging or smallholder farmers that are supported by the department are not a pilot project. They are either individual farmers or groups of farmers that have formed an agricultural cooperative who have embarked on various agricultural commodities. The farms that they occupy are mainly acquired through the land and agrarian reform programs. Some of these farms or projects do provide job opportunities on a permanent basis and temporary basis. On your second question, member, on how many farmers are supported by these projects and how has the department intervened so that these farmers are able to sell their produced goods, the response is as follows. A total of 382 smallholder farmers and land agrarian projects are supported during the 2013-2014 financial year with an agricultural production inputs. This is an effort to optimize production at farm level to ensure that food security and eventually maximize profit and further ensure that there is agricultural growth and development in the province with a focus on empowerment, poverty alleviation, income generation, and reduce unemployment and create job creation through the agricultural sector. On your other question on whether government will consider buying back these products, the department facilitates marketing opportunities for smallholder farmers to sell their produce to government institutions like hospitals, prisons, and other rehabilitation centers. The cooperatives and individual farmers are encouraged and assisted to secure contracts to supply their produce to government institutions. Your last question says we must supply the name, the location, and contact details of all these farmers located and that we have alluded to. As I said, there are 382. If I can start to mention their names shortly, it will take me 382 minutes, and I don't think that we've got that time. So I'll make the names of all these people available to the table. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Speaker. My second body question, MEC, will be probably not more of a question to say. I'm just worried in terms of the support of the farmers that are there currently. Because I think that one of the meetings that we had, Jefferson, that there were some other farmers that they were worried that the department is not actually acting quick enough in terms of assisting them in terms of the funding, and that actually impacts in terms of their cash flow. So I just want to say that we advise the department that, look, maybe it's not because that black farmers cannot farm, it's just that maybe the department must move with speed in terms of assisting and making sure that those farmers are actually assisted in time. And also, Speaker, I'm just worried in terms of the number, because you've got 382. I think I just want to say that, is it the only amount, all of the black farmers that are actually there. Because remember that due to farming, you can actually produce massive in employment. So I hope that maybe that department will actually take that advice. That you.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. The advice is noted and accepted. Obviously, we need to move with speed. No one would disagree with that. But we need to have as many people as possible in the farming industry so that they can contribute to the food security of the province. And you will see from the speech of the Premier that we are indeed targeting West Rand to be our agricultural hub in terms of economic support, including CDBA. So we indeed have more than 382 people that will assist us in that phase. I've noted your concern concerning cash flow and the need to provide additional support to these farmers. But these farmers are giving all the
resources. It's not acceptable that you ask a question, you comment. When the MEC is trying to respond, you start.